All right, it's Friday, which means one thing and one thing only, power rankings, except Dan Rosen's not here. So,
do I get to play the part of Dan Rosen?
Danny Rosen!
Danny Rosen's not here. Out.
You can take a run at our
Johnny
picks instead.
Johnny is ready. Exactly. The three of us.
I don't worry. You guys will get it. We'll get close.
Let's see. Why don't you? This is your segment. So why don't you lead the charge here with your partner.
All right. Let's go right off the bat. I think I'm wearing the same tie in that photo. All right. I got the Preds to me. I mean, if the Devils would have won last night, I would have probably had to have them at one, right?
Because
they would have won all their game, but they lost. Watching the games, the Preds have looked like the best team to me. The only game they lost, just heard Kristen talk about, a 43-save shutout by Mike Smith. Devils at 2, Maple Leafs playing great hockey, tough one last night, lost to a good opponent. The Ducks, got to give them credit. John Gibson is playing really well. Look at the record. The record is what it is. They're playing really well, so you got to have them in there.
Are they playing well?
They're winning. The bottom line, Mike, I don't know.
You know those are two different things. You can't play well and not win?
Mike, here's the reality of things, Mike. When you win, the music is on the locker room. Everybody's happy. You advance. You go to the playoffs. When you lose, even if you play well, none of that matters. Everybody's sour.
And you know, even when you're winning, when you're not playing well, and you're kind of getting by because your goaltenders are lights out.
Right? We will address this again next week, right?
So that's. But for now, NHL now.
NHL now.
Ducks are on the list, and the Canadians.
And I wouldn't put them in a seven-game series. Just about any.
Number
of the top
five, the Canadians, who you dissed the other day against the Blues, and you paid a dear price in your picks for that dissing.
This is true. All right, here's mine.
Here we go.
I have Nashville up top. Same reason. They just have looked the most solid, most complete, ready to play. Everything's kind of working for them right now. I have Colorado number two. NHL now.
They've only lost one game. They beat the Devils.
They beat New Jersey, a very good team. They play kind of split half and half on the road, so their
first
line is going.
Two overtime losses.
I do like their goaltending combination, so maybe some lasting power. Devils, very good start.
Very good.
They had a tough loss last night, but really, Europe back to North America. Yep. They look very good. Toronto Maple Leafs, even though they got shut out by Pittsburgh, still deserve to be there. And I can't punish the Tampa Bay Lightning because they don't play.
Yeah, that's true. I mean,
they've only played five games, but they've only lost one of them. And even though Steven Stamkos is maybe off to a slightly slower start than they'd like, they still look really good.
Yeah,
they have so many good players.
They're very good.
So I have them at number 5.
I can't argue with that list, and it's a wonderful headshot of you, by the way.
At least I'm wearing different clothes.
I just want to point out.
True. Yes.
The Tampa Bay Lightning have only beaten one team this season that was in the playoffs last year.
The only player who's in front of you.
Which is why they are not in my top 5. I think this is the top headshot.
First of all, that's in news and sports.
That photo is like 5 years old.
It's a great shot.
Your hair's gotten longer.
Second of all, I think we all pretty much have the same teams in there with the exception of one each. You had the Ducks each.
Yeah.
Johnny, you had Tampa, and I put the Boston Bruins in there because they are just scoring goals at a ridiculous pace. And you guys said everything else about the other teams. I'm shocked that you had Montreal in yours, though.
Yeah.
I thought I was going to take so much heat for that.
I came so ready.
I was like, they've beaten St. Louis, Pittsburgh twice.
Took a point
from the Leafs.
When I go through this, and I got the 4 I liked, and then it was a matter of who was going to be 5, and Tampa was in the mix, Colorado was in the mix, but I was like, you know what?
You can't discount what they've done so far.
You really can't.
Montreal has played very well, and we do this every week on this show, much to the chagrin of many of the fans out there, but we do it anyway. And it'll change week to week. Right now, Montreal, got to give them a lot of credit.
The only one that doesn't make any sense is Anaheim.
That's the only one that's really just, boy, you know.
Look at this. Look at this. 5-1-1, 11 points. Six more goals scored than allowed. 3-1 on the road.
What's their goaltending percentage?
It's very good.
Is the goalie part of the team?
As Mike Johnson once asked me, is the goalie part of the team?
He is part of the team.
Thank you very much. I have no further questions.
The goaltender.
I have no further questions.
Please let me rebut, please.
No further questions.